Hey guys, welcome to Ad Geek Store, and in this video I will be teaching you that how you could get rid of the activation error that is occurring on the devices that are running iOS 7 with their beta versions. Now this is because Apple recently wanted to get rid of the beta versions of their iOS 7 and they wanted to stick to the official iOS 7, and thus they are not signing the beta versions now, and the devices that are running iOS 7 with their beta versions would not work until they have the official iOS 7. So in this video I will be teaching you that how you could get the official iOS 7 when you have any beta version of iOS 7 running on your iDevice. So the first thing that you have to do is you have to take the USB cable and then you have to plug your iDevice with the computer using the USB cable. So as you can see, I have done so, and after you've done that, you have to turn off your iDevice. So you have to turn it off. So as you can see, it's turning it off. Alright, now your iDevice is turned off. Now you have to get it in the recovery mode. So for that, you have to hold the home button, the power button, together with 10 seconds, and after 10 seconds you have to release your finger from the power button and you have to continue to hold the home button for 8 seconds and then you'll be in the recovery mode. Now as soon as you get it in the recovery mode, what you will see is this USB cable on your screen with the iTunes logo on the top. And as you can see, my iDevice is connected, and when it's in the recovery mode, you will see on the screen that iTunes prompts that iTunes has detected the iPad in recovery mode. Alright, so when iTunes has detected the iDevice in the recovery mode, just click on OK. And now what you're going to do is you have to click on Restore iPad, and this will get the official iOS 7 on your iDevice. So just click on Restore iPad. Now it will prompt that, are you sure you want to restore the iPad to its factory settings? All your media and other data will be erased and the newest version of the iPad software will be installed. Now the newest version will currently be iOS 7.0.2. So as soon as you click on restore and update, you will see a bar on the top over here that will show the progress of the restore on your iDevice, and so will you see a bar on the iDevice too. And when the bar is complete, it will occur I think once or twice, and after that when you switch on your iDevice, it will be running iOS 7.0.2, the official one. So that's all about this video. I genuinely do hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to hit the like button, comment and subscribe. Thank you.